बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ हिस्टोलॉजी प्रैक्टिकल इज थायमस। थायमस इज प्राइमरी लिम्फैटिक ऑर्गन विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ टी लिम्फोसाइट्स टू द बॉडी। इट इज लोकेटेड इन सुपीरियर मिडास्टिनम। इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू लोब्स विच आर इनक्लोज्ड विद इन ए कैप्सूल ऑफ डेंस इरेगुलर कनेक्टिव टिश्यू। वेरियस सेप्टा और ट्रबैकली दे अराइज फ्रॉम द कैप्सूल and divide the parenchyma of thymus into a number of irregular lobules or compartments. Now each thymic lobule, it consists of a peripheral zone which is known as cortex and a central region which is called as medulla. Lymphatic nodes are not present in the thymus. Both the cortex and medulla of thymus, they contain T lymphocytes and thymic epithelial cells. First we'll discuss the thymic cortex. Now, thymic cortex, it contains a very high population of T lymphocytes that constitute about 95% of the total lymphocytes of thymus. This thymic cortex, it stains darkly basophilic because of the presence of densely packed immature T lymphocytes, which are known as thymocytes. Now, the peripheral region of thymic cortex in each lobule, it contains larger cells. These larger cells are called as lymphoblasts and they originate in the bone marrow and they are transferred to the thymus via the blood vessels. Now these larger cells, the lymphoblasts, they undergo proliferation and they give rise to a large number of small lymphocytes which are called as thymocytes. These thymocytes, they move from the central region, from the peripheral region to the central region of thymus. During their movement through the cortex from the periphery to the center, these thymocytes, they receive instructions to develop into immunocompetent T lymphocytes. And this process is called as thymic cell education. Now these thymocytes, they during this process, only 5% of thymocytes, they become mature, immunocompetent T lymphocytes. The rest, they undergo apoptosis and they are engulfed by the macrophages which are present in the cortex of thymus. So the 5 mature immunocompetent T lymphocytes, they reach the medulla, they enter the medulla and they leave the medulla via the post capillary venules and the efferent lymphatics. Now the thymic cortex, it contains 3 types of thymic epithelial cells: type 1, type 2 and type 3. Type 1 thymic epithelial cells are flattened cells which are located at the outer boundary of thymic cortex. These cells, they separate the cortex from the connective tissue capsule and from the trabeculae. These cells, they also surround the arteries and capillaries of thymic cortex. These cells, they play an important role in the formation of blood-thymus barrier. Now type 2 thymic epithelial cells. Type 2 thymic epithelial cells, they are located in the middle part of the cortex. And these are stellate cells which have long white sheet-like processes. These cells are also called as thymic nurse cells because they surround and envelop the developing T lymphocytes and they play an important role in the T cell education. Then the type 3 thymic epithelial cells, these are located at the junction of cortex and medulla. These cells also have sheet-like cytoplasmic processes and they isolate the cortex from the medulla and play an important role in the T-cell education. Then is the thymic medulla. Now, thymic medulla, it is the central region of each thymic lobule. It stains much lighter than the cortex because it lodges much less T lymphocytes as compared to the cortex. It contains dendritic cells and thymic epithelial cells of type 4, 5 and 6. Type 4 thymic epithelial cells possess sheet-like cytoplasmic processes. These type 4 cells, they are present at the corticomedullary junction in close association with type 3 thymic epithelial cells. So these cells, they are bound with each other and with the adjacent type 3 thymic epithelial cells via occluding junctions, and thus they form a barrier at the corticomedullary junction. Then type 5 thymic epithelial cells. These cells also possess cytoplasmic processes which are joined with the processes of the neighboring cells via desmosomes to form small compartments that contain groups of T lymphocytes. Nuclei of these thymic epithelial cells, they contain large number of euchromatin. Therefore, these cells, they stain lighter than the lymphocytic nuclei. Then are the type 6 thymic epithelial cells, which are the most important one. They constitute most distinguishing feature of thymic medulla. These cells form thymic corpuscles, which are also called as Hessel's corpuscles. These Hessel corpuscles are basically isolated masses of closely packed type 6 cells. These corpuscles are spherical or oval in structure. They are closely packed, concentrically arranged. These type 6 cells, they have flat nuclei and their cytoplasm is markedly eosinophilic. And the adjacent cells are joined to each other by desmosomes, and the central cell of Hessel's corpuscles, it becomes keratinized or becomes calcified. These cells, they produce cytokines which play an important role in T cell education. Now this is the microscopic structure of thymus. We can see that the connective tissue capsule is surrounding the thymus. From this connective tissue capsule, trabeculae or septa arise and divides this thymus into incomplete or indistinct compartments or lobules. The outer portion is basophilic because of the presence of large number of T lymphocytes, whereas the central portion, which is called as medulla, it stains lighter as compared to the cortex because it contains less number of T lymphocytes as compared to the cortex. Now this is the histological diagram of the thymus. We can see the two lobes of thymus are present in this diagram. Connective tissue capsule surrounds the lobes. The connective tissue capsule contains collagen fibers, elastic fibers, fibroblasts, and blood vessels. Now this connective tissue capsule, from this connective tissue capsule, trabeculae or septa arise and divide the lobes into incomplete or indistinct compartments. Now, we can see in the cortex, thymocytes are present. Cortex is darkly basophilic, and thymocytes. They are of three types, type 1, type 2, type 3. Thymic epithelial cells are present, and in medulla, we can see Hessel corpuscles are present, which are made up of type cells, the type 6 thymic epithelial cells, and few thymocytes are present. Now you can see that the number of thymocytes is very less in medulla as compared to that of cortex. Now this was end of lecture. Thank you.